AgenticFlow allows you to build sales and marketing AI agents that can speak with your customers on your behalf. It can even run automations with other tools, even generates images and video. Now watch this AgenticFlow review and demo to learn about my honest thoughts about this tool. Now, AgenticFlow is one of 16 tools that launched for AI Week. And to celebrate, AppSumo was kind enough to partner with me to offer a tier 3 giveaway to one lucky winner that's valued at $409. Now, entering is free and easy. All you need to do is click the link in my description, then add your first name and email, and you'll be entered into the giveaway instantly. And I will pick one lucky random winner in about 5 days when the giveaway ends. Now, there are two parts to AgenticFlow. Okay, so you have your agents and you have your workflows. The workflows are the backend pieces that you can connect to an agent, and then you can share your agent with your audience and they can interact with the agent, ask it any questions, generate any types of images and video. The tool offers you 4 agent templates that you can use to start off with. One can generate images, one offers customer support, another one does market research, and you also have an agent that can create videos. And these agents are tied to some of these workflows right here, and they have tons of workflow templates that you can use to start off with. You can generate AI images, quick QR art, you can scrape URLs, extract data from PDFs, so on and so forth. Now, I think what makes AgenticFlow really powerful and unique are the connections and the MCP servers. So with connections, you can connect your YouTube and you can connect custom API keys like OpenAI, Google Gemini, Anthropic, so on and so forth. Now, to use AgenticFlow properly, I would suggest connecting your Pixel ML account. Now, this is an open router from AgenticFlow that you can use to generate images and video. And it's pretty easy to add your API keys to any of these. Now, let me try to connect my YouTube. I'm going to click on Create Connection, give it a name, and then click on Connect. So I just need to follow the step-by-step instructions here, and I do get a notification that says Google hasn't verified this app. So I'm going to click on Advanced, then click on Go to AgenticFlow AI, then click on Continue. I'm going to allow it to manage my YouTube videos, then click on Continue. Okay, so as you could see here, it says failed to connect to YouTube. Please try again later. So I believe this is a bug, unfortunately. So as of this recording, you cannot connect to your YouTube channel. You also can connect to a variety of MCP servers. Now, that stands for Model Context Protocol Servers, which act as a bridge that allows AI models to interact with external tools. And you can connect with tons of tools like Klaviyo, Notion, Slack, Google Sheets, Zoom, so on and so forth. I really like how they have tons of enterprise tools as well. So I did connect my OpenAI account, also Google Sheets, Drive, and Docs. It's very easy to connect your MCP servers. So if you want to connect, for example, Salesforce, just follow these simple 4 steps, then click on Add MCP Server, and this will make your AI agents very powerful, and I'll show you that right now. So I'm gonna click on Create App, and I wanna create an agent that can write SEO blog posts. So I gave it a name and description, and you can also add an icon as well, so you can select an emoji or upload an image. Now let me search for a writing type of emoji. Let me see, write or journal. Okay, so for whatever reason, when I try to search for an emoji, nothing shows up, but you can also add an image from your computer as well. Now it looks like I could select this thumbs up emoji, so I'm just gonna select that, then click on Create Agent. Okay, so this is where we can edit our AI agent. This is where you add your system prompt that the AI agent will follow. And this middle column here are the skills, knowledge, and chat experience. So you can connect workflows that you create or add any templates from AgenticFlow. I have a handful of workflows here. Now, if I click on templates, you could take a look at all of the AgenticFlow pre-populated workflow templates. Now I'm gonna add my SEO optimized blog post generator workflow. And for the MCPs, we can add those as well. So I wanna give my AI agent the ability to upload to my Google Drive. So I'm gonna add Google Drive, and we can also edit the chat experience, like give it a welcome message, and also offer suggested messages as well. So these are kind of like suggested prompts. And you can select between GPT-4o Mini and Gemini 2.0 Flash. And this is where you can preview the chat on the right-hand side. Now I created an SEO blog writer earlier, so I'm gonna go back and show you how I set it up. So it's this one here, blog writer. So I'm gonna click on edit agent. So as you can see, I added my workflow and also the Google Docs MCP. Now, for whatever reason, the system prompt did not save. Now I'm going to add the system prompt again, then click on save. So I basically said, you are a professional blog writer. Your job is to create or write clear, engaging, well-structured blog posts on topics provided by the user. Each post should have a catchy title, include an introduction, so on and so forth. Now I clicked on save, so this should save. And when you click on publish, you do have a variety of options. So you can make it private just to you, or you can make it public. Now, when you make it public, you can embed this on your website, add it to Shopify, WordPress, Magento, and BigCommerce. And these social media profiles are coming soon. Okay, so I went back and I'm gonna click on edit agent again. And for whatever reason, the system prompt does not save. So I believe that is a bug, unfortunately. But let's try to use the agent. So I'm gonna say, write a blog article about how to grow an herb garden. Now let's see what my AI agent comes up with. Okay, so as you can see, it's running the workflow SEO optimized blog post generator. Okay, so it's running the workflow, and I'll show you how that workflow looks like in a moment. Okay, so the AI agent is done, and it looks like it generated a pretty nicely built out blog article titled How to Start an Herb Garden, a step-by-step guide. So we have the introduction, all of the headings for the blog. It also included a conclusion and an FAQ section. Now, since I added the Google Docs MCP, what I could do is open up a blank Google Doc and copy the URL, and then ask it to move this blog data into this Google Doc. So I said, send this to my Google Doc, and I provided it with the URL, and it says, the blog article has been successfully added to your Google Doc. You could view it here. And here we go. So we have all of the text that the AI agent generated for us inside my Google Doc. So that what makes AgenticFlow so powerful are the MCP servers that you can connect to the tool. Now let me show you the workflow that was connected to the AI agent. So it's this one right here, SEO optimized blog post generator. And this is the workflow, okay? So the first step is the user inputs. So I added the specific word count, the blog post type, awareness stage, so on and so forth as examples. And then this is the content outline. So this is an action, okay? So this is essentially the first step, okay? So you need to add a connection. So I connected my Pixel ML open router connection, and this is the prompt. You can also choose the model as well. So it's using Claude 3 Haiku. And then after this first step goes the blog post generation, and this is the prompt for that, which allows the agent to create the blog post. I also created this icon maker AI agent as well. Now this one generates icons for me. So if I click on Edit Agent, so this is the system prompt, which I'm grateful that it did save. And then I did connect it to this workflow, and I added these MCPs here, Google Drive, Sheets, and OpenAI. And as you could see right here, I was testing out the chat. Now let me click on Use Agent. Now let me show you what this one does. Cat running with its tongue out. Okay, so let's see what this AI agent will generate. Okay, so it's running through the workflow. Now what I could also do is tell it to add it to my Google Drive. So I created this AgenticFlow folder in my Google Drive and I copied the URL. And then I basically told it to add it here with the URL. And then the AI agent instantly added this image to my Google Drive. Now let me open it and it is right here. And it does all of this in a matter of seconds. Now let me show you the workflow for that. So it's generate transparent icons. So it's these two-step workflow. So this is the user input. It's very simple. It's just a text prompt. You also have the option to add numbers, a Boolean, image to URL, so on and so forth. And then this first step is to generate an image. So I connected it to Pixel ML and you can select the provider. So Runware, DALL-E, or Stable Diffusion. And then this is the prompt, okay? You need to add a negative prompt, select your aspect ratio. And then for the next step is to remove the background. And that's essentially it. Now, when it comes to adding steps, you can click on Add New Step. And these are the popular ones right here from Pixel ML. So JSON to Google Sheet, you can extract content, send an email, image compare, so on and so forth. Now, in terms of other actions, you have OpenAI actions, like you can ask the assistant, generate an image, do an audio transcription, do deep research as well. There's also Perplexity, Anthropic, and then these are the other Pixel ML actions you can choose from. There's also YouTube, Google Gemini, so on and so forth. Now, one thing to note is that when it comes to the MCP servers, you cannot add an action from the servers that you connect, unfortunately. The only thing you can do right now is basically tell it what to do inside the chat. Okay, so what I mean in terms of actions is, you know, if you go to MCP server and click on, you know, the tools, these are all of the specific tools or actions you can do. So you can upload a file to your Google Drive, you can move a file to the trash, find spreadsheets, download a file, so on and so forth. Now, unfortunately, you cannot choose these as actions. Now, in terms of maybe Google Sheets, these are the specific tools or actions from the Google Sheets MCP, like update a row, insert a row, update a cell, so on and so forth. Now, to activate these tools, you basically need to tell it what to do. So you can just say, insert a row to this Google Sheet and then provide it with the link to the Google Sheet, and then it'll automatically add that row, kind of like what I showed you with Google Drive and also the Google Docs example. Now, in your chat view, you can chat with all of the AI agents that you've created right here, and you can also generate images as well. They have a handful of really nice examples here. You can remix them. Let me remix this 3D art of a keyboard, and you can choose from a variety of AI models like Flux One, Schnell, Stable Diffusion, so on and so forth. And this is the prompt. And if I click on this icon, it'll give me another random prompt. You can choose between standard definition, high definition, or fidelity, and then the dimensions, and select additional settings right here. And let's click on generate, and it says, please select a connection active. Okay, so now it's selected, click on generate, and let's see what it comes up with. Okay, here we go. So a picture of a bird embroidered on white cloth. So it actually looks really good. So I'm pretty impressed with how this generates images. Now, I was testing this tool for a couple of days, and I did run into a few bugs, and you did see those bugs as well. Thankfully, you can easily contact support. They do have a Discord, and they have a community. And this is their community, and I was communicating with support the other day about me not being able to find the MCP actions in the workflow builder. And they're pretty responsive, very helpful, which I'm very grateful for. They also have a Discord channel as well, where you can chat with the team and other users. So I just showed you just a sliver of what AgenticFlow can do. But as you could see in terms of the workflows, there's tons of very powerful workflows that you can connect to an AI agent, share it with your customers, use it yourself to generate images, video, and do other productivity actions for your specific use case and business. Now, here are my honest thoughts on AgenticFlow. So in terms of the pros, I say support is quick to respond in their message board. I did come across a handful of roadblocks, but their support was really nice, which I'm happy for. There's also tons of MCP servers that are available for you to connect. I think this is what makes it really powerful. You can also connect with other popular large language models. And as you just saw, there are tons of workflow templates to get you started. And I would say the interface is relatively easy to use. Now, in terms of the cons, you cannot add MCP tools as actions in your workflow as of right now, but I believe support mentioned that that is part of their roadmap. So hopefully soon you can do that. And the tool does have some bugs here and there. Like for example, the app icon does not load emojis and I cannot connect to my YouTube. It can also get frustrating building out workflows because you can run into errors. And I also said I cannot connect to my YouTube channel, which I did mention right here under the bugs. So should you buy AgenticFlow? Yes, no, or maybe? I say maybe, but leaning heavily yes. Reason being is because as of today, you will encounter a few bugs throughout the platform. But what gives me confidence in this tool is the helpful support. I really like how they have their own community board and Discord channel, so they are very easy to get a hold of. And there are tons of MCP servers that you can connect with, and you can add your own custom API keys. Now, I think as the tool matures, this will become very powerful because of the wide variety of integrations you can implement. So I do recommend getting this tool, but be aware that there will be some bugs throughout the platform, but as the tool matures, I hope they squash those bugs and just make this tool much more powerful. Now, if you're interested in the AgenticFlow AppSumo lifetime deal, you can grab it starting at $59 for license tier 1. And if you are a Plus member, you can grab license tier 4 for $749. Now, keep in mind that if you are a Plus member, you do get everything 10% off, so this will be 10% less. But if you want the WhatsApp and LinkedIn integrations, you would need to get tier 3 or 4. And if you want a free license tier 3, I'm running a giveaway in partnership with AppSumo. So if you click the link in my description, add your first name and email, you'll be instantly entered into this free giveaway. I'll pick one random lucky winner in about 5 days.